Welcome back, movie lovers. Imagine getting stranded on the world's fourth tallest structure. Crazy, right? I know you must be craving to know what really happened, so don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let's jump right into it. The movie starts with the appearance of a couple climbing a mountain accompanied by the wife's friend named Hunt. The wife is named Becky and the husband, Dan. While climbing, Dan loses control and falls down, but fortunately he is suspended by his climbing rope. He tries to push himself to the mountain while Becky and Hunt keep screaming out of fear. Unfortunately, the rope holding Dan couldn't support the weight anymore and it loses Dan's grip, leading to him falling to his death. Becky stares in silence as she watches her husband fall to his death. 51 weeks later, Becky's house can be seen disorganized as her father's voice note plays in the background. Becky is seen drinking in the bar. It is obvious she is still mourning Dan's death. She calls Dan's phone just to hear his voice play over the pre-recorded voice note. Becky leaves to go home when she encounters her dad outside the bar. He tries to convince her to move on but to no avail. When Becky gets home, she tries to overdose herself before Hunt knocks on the door. Hunt hugs her and shares her plan to climb the B67 TV tower, the fourth tallest structure in the world. She explains to Becky that she needs to do this and overcome her fears and also scatter Dan's ashes at the top. Becky refuses while crying. It appears she hasn't climbed again after Dan's death. The following morning, Becky wakes up to grab a snack from the kitchen cupboard when she sees a portrait of Dan. This somehow motivates her and she approaches Becky in the toilet and tells her that she agrees to climb. Becky happily hugs her and they embark on the 6 hours drive to the tower. During the journey, Becky watches old videos on Hunt's phone. They arrive at a motel where Hunt reveals that she amassed over 60,000 subscribers on YouTube by posting herself doing dangerous things. Becky is intrigued by this fact. Hunt asks the waitress if she can charge her phone, but the waitress doesn't want to charge her phone for free. They further ask for directions to the B67 TV tower because they couldn't find it on the map. So Hunt uses this opportunity to show Becky a very cool life hack. She uses the lampstand on their table to charge her phone by removing the light bulb and using her connecting her charger to the lamp holder. The following morning, Becky dreams of waking. Besides Dan, who uses a code, 143, to tell Becky that he loves her, before the bedsheet soaks with blood, leading to Becky waking up. She goes out to meet Hunt outside. Hunt starts to record them. They almost get hit by a lorry, so Hunt puts down the camera and continues the drive. They are blocked by a gate, so they walk the remaining distance before encountering a dead animal being eaten by vultures. Becky and Hunt rush to save it, but it is too late. When they eventually reach the tower, Becky develops cold feet and starts crying that she isn't crying anymore, but Becky encourages her. Becky and Hunt begin climbing the tower using the interior ladder. While climbing, it can be seen how old and loose the screws of the ladder are. Pretty risky if you ask me. After reaching a height of 1,000 feet, the duo decide to rest before continuing the journey. After climbing 1,600 feet, the remaining 200 feet have been climbed using an exterior ladder. The ladies summon courage and begin to climb despite the loose screws. On the way, Becky starts to get afraid. Hunt tells her to sing a nursery rhyme to keep herself busy. Eventually, they both reach the top. They celebrate and take selfies of themselves. They also use a drone to record themselves live on the tower. After a while, they hang over the tip of the top to get a shot of themselves. After celebrating, Becky takes the ashes of Dan. She cries while saying a farewell message before she throws it into the air. When she discovers Hunt crying, she consoles her and they decide to go back down. Becky is the first to attempt it. The ladders lose control and they bend over. Becky tries to get a hold of herself before the ladders fall to the ground. Becky is saved by Hunt as she drags Becky back with the rope. The two of them decide to go back down when they discover the ladder has been disconnected from the pole and they have no way down. Becky starts to panic, but Hunt calms her down. They realize that Becky has been severely injured on her leg. They discover a box attached to the pole and they open it to unveil some things like a set of binoculars and a flare gun. Becky films Hunter, who reveals how pained she is for Dan's death. They both decide to send a distress signal using Hunt's YouTube audience, but unfortunately they don't have a signal up the tower. After trying to lower the phone a bit with no avail, they decide to pad the phone and throw it down the tower, hoping it will catch the signal and send the distress message. They throw it down the tower and monitor it with the binoculars, hoping to hear a sound from the phone, but they don't hear anything. Becky discovers a 143 tattoo on Hunter's leg. After a while, they see a man and a dog. They start to throw things like their shoes, but unfortunately the man does not look up. Later in the night, they see the man and another person in a bus, so they shoot the flare gun and use their flashlight to call their attention. It works, the men finally see them. The men drive their bus towards them, but they stop at their car and steal it. The ladies are thrown into despair. After a while, Becky asks Hunt about the 1-4-3 tattoo on her leg. It is discovered that Dan actually cheated on Becky with Hunt. Hunt apologizes. The following morning, she apologizes again after she tells Becky about how special Dan made her feel. After a while, another idea popped into their heads to send a handwritten note to the motel using the drone. Hunter volunteers to go down and retrieve the bag where the drone is and water. Using the rope, Hunter lowers herself down until she is a foot away from the bag. She jumps over to the antenna where the bag is. She retrieves the bag and throws it on the rope with the selfie stick. She jumps on the rope and Becky starts to pull her up immediately. At a point, Becky loses control of the rope, which makes Hunt fall down. But fortunately, she fell on the bag and her palm was damaged from the friction trying to hold the rope, so she couldn't climb. So Becky had to pull her back up. Becky quickly finds the drone and uses Hunt's makeup tool to write the script. After writing the message and attaching it to the drone, Becky begins to fly the drone towards the hotel. Unfortunately, the drone's battery is too low and begins to shut down, so Becky quickly retrieves it back. Later that night, Becky gets a nightmare about Becky dying before she wakes up. Then Becky gets an idea to use Hunt's life hack to use the lamp holder on the tower to charge the drone. The following morning, Becky climbs up the pole to charge the drone. She hangs painfully while resisting a vulture. Her bag falls down in the process. She notices that Becky doesn't catch it. After the drone charges fully, she climbs back down. Becky is weak and begins to lose herself. They both agree to fly the drone to the motel at checkout time by 10 a.m. Hunt engages Becky in a conversation to keep her spirit alive. The following morning, Becky flies the drone to the motel, but unfortunately a lorry crashes into it. Becky is thrown into despair. Hunt tries to console Becky. An idea pops into Becky's head to use Hunt's shoe as a pad for phone, while they throw it down in case it manages to catch a signal. Hunt tells Becky that her shoe is down. This statement seems strange to Becky until Hunt reveals that she actually died when she fell earlier. It is revealed that Becky has been talking to a ghost all this while. Becky's dad can be seen worrying about the whereabouts of his daughter. The following morning, a vulture tries to eat out of Becky's wound, but she catches it and kills it. She then proceeded to eat the vulture raw. After getting some energy, she climbs down to Hunt's body and encounters a vulture that she uses her stare to scare away. Becky then uses Hunt's body as a cushion for her phone. She types a distress message ready to upload whenever the phone detects a signal. She puts the phone inside Hunt's shoe before inserting it into her body before throwing it down. Fortunately, Becky's dad can be seen driving towards the tower. It appears the message was sent. When Becky's father arrives at the tower, he meets the emergency team there. He sees a body on the floor thinking it is Becky until Becky calls him from behind and hugs him tightly. We've come to the end of the movie, and I must admit that this movie has to be one of the best released this year. Every minute was captivating. The interesting twist about Hunt's death and the suspense makes this a perfect piece. Rate this movie on a scale of 10 and let me know your opinions in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe. I can't take no loss. I don't need no-